Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, I'll be reviewing the service called Freedom Pop. Now, basically what it is a cell phone service that runs on Sprint's network, and they offer free to really cheap service plans. So the free plan gets you 500 megabytes of data, 500 texts, and 200 minutes of calling. Now, how this works is basically you put in a SIM card that you buy from Freedom Pop. They do charge you for the SIM card. It's only $1.99, so it's not too bad. And you just go and pop it into an old phone or just whatever phone you want. You can also buy a refurbished phone off of their website, but I highly, highly advise not doing that. They say it's about 50% off of MSRP, but it's actually marked up a little bit, and they're also refurbished. All right, so once you got the SIM card in your phone, you just download the Freedom Pop messaging app. It's available in iOS and Android. So you just go and open that up, and it's basically like a text message window. You can also choose the dial pad to call people. You can choose the plus to start a text message, and the text message conversations just look like normal conversations. The app isn't bad. It's perfectly fine for what you need to get done. And then if you go over here on the left side, it shows you all of your statistics of how much data you have left, how many minutes you have left, and how many text messages you have left. Now, as you can see right now, I have about a gigabyte of data and unlimited minutes and texts. I'm on the free trial for the next tier up, that plan. I think it's about 20 bucks a month, so $20 a month for a gigabyte of data and unlimited texting and calling. You choose if you think that's a good deal. I'm going to probably downgrade to the free plan after this because, I mean, I'm on T-Mobile. I don't really need this too badly. But anyways, that's what you get for 20 bucks a month. They also have other plans that go up to like $45 or something. You can choose whatever plan you need. Just make sure that you have Sprint's coverage. All right, so let's go ahead and review this service just a little bit. So setup was pretty easy, just putting in the SIM card into my phone. Unfortunately, right away, my Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge didn't recognize the SIM card. I needed to reboot a couple times and also change the access point name or whatever that APN stands for. But it wasn't too bad. Once I got it up and running, I was able to connect to the 4G network. I didn't get any LTE signal. It says on their website that they do have LTE, but I was not able to connect to that. And overall, in my area, Sprint coverage is pretty good. So I was getting 3 or 4 bars pretty much wherever I was. As far as the data speeds go, I didn't get above 2 megabits per second down, and upload was pretty much nothing. But anyways, 2 megabits per second down for a free plan, it's not too bad. One thing I really don't like about Freedom Pop is their website and their whole plans and everything. It's really sketchy. Just you have to be really careful on their website. The option to downgrade your plan is probably a size 6 font on their website. So if you sign up for that trial, make sure you have your glasses on so you can see that. But overall, for $2 for buying the SIM card and 500 megabytes of data per month, you know, it's not too bad. For the price of free, you're getting a lot. There's also some other benefits to having this service, like you get a free VPN service, I think Freedom Pop Private Internet, basically just a VPN service, so if you want to use that, you can do that. You also get a voicemail and access to their Wi-Fi networks nationwide. I'm not too sure which Wi-Fi networks they connect to. I think they're partnered, they might be partnered with AT&T on this one, but yeah, so Wi-Fi, it's always a good thing. As far as call quality and all that stuff goes, you know, it's okay. It's just Sprint's regular call quality. It's not voice over LTE. It's not HD voice. It's not anything like that. Just regular calling. But anyways, guys, I think that's it for this video. Nothing more to talk about, really. It's a free service, and you get 500 megabytes of data per month. You can't complain. So if you have $2 to spare, you can't go wrong with buying a SIM card from this place. And then just make sure you downgrade your plan so you don't get charged $20 the next month. Anyways, guys, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.